services. They do some really great things out in the community, providing services, insurance, and financial services to small business and nonprofit organizations. So if you ever want anyone to really do some great work for you and folks who are making a big difference in the community, make sure you check out Jimmy Comer, Chris Smith of Community First and RBI Services. One of the groups I always like to give a shout out to with them is the Ford Foundation. They used to be the Sophie House, providing child services for single moms. So shout out to Andrea and all the folks over at the Ford Foundation. Folks, along the way, we have to pay some bills, and make sure you take care of some of our partners, our advertising partners. They work hard out there in the community providing services, and plus they help keep me on the air, which I appreciate. Plus my grandkids need stuff, and my wife wants me to make it happen. So I can say, so today's show, folks, we strive to bring you the game changers in the area, and today is no exception. On today's show, we have Tamika Vincent, who is a community activist. She's also running for the 6th District for the Richmond School District. So we'll talk to her and the endeavors that she has. She's a nonprofit. We know some of the same people. She's been out there fighting for children for a long time, and it's just morphed into running for school board. And we're going to talk about her and that journey. Also going to talk to my friend Nicole Reed of Nicole Reed Real Estate, the top real estate agent in the city. We go a long way back. She's a talk show host. She's a mom. She's my business partner, and she's going to tell us what's happening in the world of real estate and why houses are jumping off the market. Folks, the time is 1:10. The program is On the Mic with Mike. You're listening to us on WJFN 100.5, 92.7 FM, 820 AM. I'm your host, Mike King, and I'm glad to be here. And with that being said, we would like to welcome in Tamika Vincent. Hello, ma'am.
Hey, Mike, how are you doing?
I'm doing pretty good. So I see, so folks who are looking at us on Facebook, we're glad to have you here, but you brought some help with you.
I did.
You brought some support.
I did. I brought my 7-year-old son, Tyler.
Okay.
He's the upcoming second grader at John B. Carey Elementary School.
Good enough. So we're going to talk to him a little later on in the program. Let's talk about your journey and what your background is and your vision of how you see the world, Richmond specific, the 6th District, and your candidacy for a school board.
Okay. So my name's Tamika Vincent, like you said. I am a Richmonder. I've been here. I've gone to Richmond Public Schools, started at Overby Shepherd Elementary School, and went to Henderson Middle School, John Marshall High School, J. Sergeant Reynolds, and VCU. And so ended up finishing with human services and health services. And I'm a respiratory therapist at Children's Hospital of Richmond. And I started a nonprofit that is called Wealth Building Solutions. A few of the things that Wealth Building Solutions is doing in the community, we are a 501c3. We basically help those people that are in need within the community with job training, workforce development, and opportunities for residency. We kind of gear toward the homeless population and those that are having difficulties finding jobs.
Okay, so how did the idea of being a community servant, how'd that all come about? Like, have you always been that person?
I think as a child, just kind of being in a unstable environment as a young child, and then having to move with my father and my grandparents, you know, I think one of the things that, and living with my grandparents, one of the things that just kind of made me know, you know, my grandparents' mother would always say, you need to serve others. You need to do something for someone else other than yourself. And just always serve and do right by other people.
Okay.
And so that has always stuck with me.
Ladies and gentlemen, the voice you're listening to is Tamika Vincent, candidate for the 6th District for the school board. That's important, but also community servant, telling us about the nonprofit that she had founded. So how does the nonprofit come about?
So the nonprofit is me starting at my church, doing just outreach service. We would do book bag drives. We would go out and pass out gas cards, and we would go out and just feed and serve and just do all types of things in the neighborhood. But I, you know, that was fine, but I just wanted to do more. I felt like there was more to be done. At the time, I lived in Chesterfield, and my husband and I ended up moving to the city of Richmond. And I realized we would drive around sometimes at night, and I would see just people laying out on the street. Okay. And just people not having a way of life and jobs. And I told him, I was like, we got to do something. I want to do more in the city, in the street.
Okay.
And
so when I met you, come a little closer to the microphone for me.
Okay.
So when I met you, we were over at Martin Luther King with Shelby Brown for Missions of the Heart.
Mm-hmm.
And you were volunteering then.
Yeah. So I had been volunteering with the Councilwoman of Richmond, Ellen Robinson, which is in the 6th District, because that's the area that me and my husband moved in. And I went to her and I was like, you know, can I help you in the community? What can I do in the community? And so she just let me shadow her for a few months. And then I saw where my need was, which was in her schools. I just, reached out. She allowed me to have the connection to reach out to those schools. From that, I would talk to the principals of that school and found out some of the issues that was going on within the schools. One of the things was hunger with the schools and with the kids. And so in the process of doing that, we started a closet. And at the time, my grandmother, because she's just still in my heart and just remembering some of the things she said, we started closets called Closets of Grace. And we put those closets in within MLK, Belle Meade, and Overbee Shepherd. And we donated, the councilwoman donated $1,000 to those closets to get those closets started. And then we would take food and clothing and items, personal items, to the schools for those kids that were in need or came to school that were hungry.
So you saw the need there.
Mm-hmm.
I remember talking to you, and you had said that you would look around for somebody to make a difference to run for office.
Mm-hmm.
And that person settled to be you. Let's talk a little bit about that.
So, with me doing those different programs like that and knowing that one of the issues was hunger, and my son went to John B. Carey Elementary School, and I became the PTA president of that school. And I started realizing how all the resources that I was beginning to bring into that school to help with funding and programming in the afternoon for kids, and just needing the community and asking the community for help, they said yes. And I felt good about that. And I saw just bringing parent and getting parent engagement. And I saw the school and the teachers just kind of making, bringing programs for the teachers. And I saw how those things made that area school just become a lot better. The morale was better. And I started realizing, hey, if I can do these things over here and bring all these situations and these resources to the school, I can definitely do the same thing over in my district, which is the 6th District, to those schools that we had already started some things happening within that district.
All righty, folks, that's Tamika Vincent. We have a couple minutes left here before the break. Give us some, and so we're gonna move over to your candidacy now.
Okay.
And we'll talk a little bit about what you see that's there now that you want to make changes to, that we'll go away for a break because we have to take care of some things.
Okay.
And then when we come back, we'll talk about a little bit more. But the floor is yours now to talk a little bit about your candidacy.
Okay. Thank you.
So go ahead.
Okay. All right. So me running, like I said, I saw those things and I just realized that I wanted to bring my son over into my district to go to school. I wanted to provide more resources and more programming. So the first thing I thought I needed, or what I need, is support from the community. I know that that's a big thing when we all come together and we can do things as a collaborative source. And another thing I knew I needed was just building the teachers up and allowing them to know that we support them. and allowing them to know that they have support within the community and from the parents that are in the schools. So I wanted to do more parent engagement, with teachers and students and administration to discuss building stronger schools. I want to do wellness. I am in the health profession myself, so I wanted to bring those wellness clinics to the schools that are in my district to keep, talking about nutrition and how we, kids need to eat and sleep and bring those things to the parents so they can be educated on that. And then cultivate, relationships across education with the government and community, increase a collaborative impact so that all these things come together and it builds better camaraderie for our school, increase vocational training within the school for career ready and technical education and certifications that our kids have an option if they decide not to go to college.
All right.
Those things are there for them. And then just build a school of excellence so that our schools are accredited and we are building better programming for, beyond average readers. Those type of programs increase just the academic level of learning in our schools.
All righty, folks, that's the enlightened voice of Tamika Vincent running for school board. The program is on the mic with Mike. The time is 1:20. As I said, we have to go away and take care of some things. We'll be back on the other side with some more conversation with Tamika.
Chris Chip here with Focus Floors, and for the month of May, we are offering a free upgrade in any Bono water-based poly for any job that gets put on our schedule. You can reach us at focushardwoodflooring.com or just check us out on Facebook or Instagram. Facebook, Focus Floors 804, Instagram 80Floors. Thank you.
Did you know embroidery is an easy, low-cost way to market your business? Let Godmama Wear LLC assist you with your custom logo embroidery needs. Whether you need shirts, hats, or yoga mats, Godmama Wear can embroider various items. Visit us online at www.godmamawear.com. That's www.godmamawear.com. Let's talk soon.
Hi, my name is Kashfia Rashid, but you can call me Cash. I am an accounting strategist. I help business owners set up and maintain a customized automated bookkeeping system. You see, accounting is the language of business, but not all small business owners are fluent. I translate accounting into English, empowering my clients to work in their zones of genius with comprehensive reports that easily show them the opportunities they can take advantage of to grow their business. I use automation to take care of the daily transaction processing, freeing up time, energy, and resources, all while restoring peace and sanity. All companies need a little cash. You can find out more on my website, www.cashthebookkeeper.com.
Let Socialita help your business stand out from the crowd by building your brand success through social media management. We're located at 1510 Willalon Drive, Suite 100. Our website is www.socialitarva.com. You can also give us a call at 804-484-2001. Again, 804-484-2001. Socialita.
Thank you, attorneys Justin Lauder and Chris Gatewood at Threshold Counsel PC for sponsoring this program. They offer startup, business, and intellectual property services for innovative and growing organizations. You can find them online at threshold.cc.
Hi, I'm Reba Hollingsworth with CBS.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to On the Mic with Mike. I'd like to thank my man Al Green for the smooth sounds there. We're here with Tamika Vincent talking about her candidacy for school board, also her advocacy for children. We got Nicole Reed waiting in the wings there to come on and talk about real estate after that. Madam, the floor is yours to continue with what you were talking about.
Okay. I know, as you know, everyone always asks the same question, you know, why did you choose to take this road? And I didn't. It's like, this was something that if I had to, I was telling my husband this morning, if I had to think of something I was doing, going to be doing 5 years from 5 years ago.
Running for school board would not have been at the top of that
would
list.
Not have been anywhere at the top of the list. Nowhere in the top of the list.
But you were looking for somebody to stand out and help the kids, and you looked around and it was you.
I think I wouldn't say it was. I'm so, you know, I'm one of those people to like to stay in the back.
Yes.
I'll do things, have great ideas, but I like to stand in the back. I like to be the person to say, hey, let's do this, and we get it going, and it works out, and it's great. And I don't have to be in front of the scene. I've always been like that. If it's done, it's done. And so this has made me come out more, and it pushes me to have to come out and tell people what I want to do. But the first thing I want to do, I want to listen to people. You know, I don't know everything. I'm not a I, I'm a we. I just said I like to work, collaborate with people. I want to listen to the needs, you know, and the concerns of our children and the parents and the teachers. I want to support and develop programs that will improve the quality of education for our children. I want to work. I'm gonna work hard, as I've been doing for the last 5 years.
How can folks get involved with you to help make that happen?
They can get involved with me through email, which is my email is tsvincent.tv@gmail.com, or they can go on my website, Tamika Vincent for School Board mail.com, or they can call me. 804-237-3161.
And do you need, are you looking for volunteers? Talk to us a little bit about what you need to help your candidacy to help your vision become a reality for the kids of the 6th District.
So right now, you know, with COVID-19, I have to be extra careful.
Yes, I do.
So we would be knocking on doors right now, but that's something that I would love for people to request to happen, for us to come over and have conversation, front porch conversations with them, or they can do some call, you know, phone banking with me as I call people and let them know how I want to make changes in our schools and how they can help me once I get that seat. Because like I said, it's going to take a lot of parent engagement, a lot of community involvement, and a lot of people just coming together to move this thing forward.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, that is Tamika Vincent talking about her candidacy for school board. So let me ask you, what's the biggest difference that you see between what's happening now and what you propose to happen? What is the biggest thing, the biggest challenge right now?
I would say the biggest challenge right now, because we're in the process of going virtual for next year, I would think just that support that I'm asking for from the community and from our parents is just supporting the parents, supporting the teachers, and supporting our students. We need to actually find a way to make this thing work. It can work.
Okay.
I went to school through virtual learning on some parts of my education. So this thing can work. We just have to find a way to develop a process that it works.
Folks, the time is, I'm sorry, the time is 1:28. Give us about a minute, so we have a couple minutes left. Give us a minute on being a mom now in 2020, COVID, the unrest in society.
Wow. Now
that's the one we came here for.
Yeah, so, you know, being a mom right now is hard. I'm not gonna sit here and tell you that it's easy at all. It's very hard. I worry about my son's mental capacity because we're having to stay in. His social development, he's only talking to me and my 20-year-old son, who doesn't talk that much. He plays his video game. And then my husband. So I worry about just his mental capacity.
Gotcha. All right, so folks, what you can see in the background is the husband sitting over there. So this is the brain trust for the candidacy. So we want to get your son in to have a little bit of a talk. He wants to be a YouTuber. So, hello, how you doing?
Good.
Okay, can you give us your name?
Tyler.
Tyler. Okay, are you happy to be at the radio station?
Yes.
Okay, you excited about being on the air?
Yes.
You want to give a shout-out to some of your friends? No? No shout-outs? You excited that Mom's running for office and he brought you here?
Yes.
All righty, folks. We'd like to thank Tyler for coming in. So one last time, let folks know how. We got about 30 seconds, and let folks know how they can find you and help you out again.
Okay, so if you need to get in contact with me, it's Tamika Vincent. It's Tamika Vincent for School Board 2020. Also, you can reach out to me from tsvincent.gmail.com. And 804-237-3161.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you, Tamika, for coming in. The time's 1:29. We have to go away, and we'll be back on the other side. Thanks now.
Thanks.
With SRN News, I'm John Scott. The White House has dropped a bid to cut Social Security payroll taxes as Republicans unveil a $1 trillion COVID-19 rescue package. The tax cut had been opposed by top Senate GOP allies. Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell's package is an opening GOP bid in talks with top Capitol Hill Democrats. Major airlines reporting huge second quarter losses and warning that the recovery in air travel seen in April has stalled now as coronavirus cases surge in the U.S. American Airlines posting a loss of more than $2 billion. Southwest Airlines lost $915 million. Not a good sign in Japan. The city of Tokyo announcing a record 366 new daily coronavirus cases. That exceeds 300 for the first time. The Dow is down 168 points and the Nasdaq 152 points lower. This is SRN News.
Trading involves financial risk and is not suitable for all investors.
Stock market have you nervous with all the massive fluctuations? With the impact of coronavirus and the upcoming election, it's virtually impossible to guess what will happen next. With Vantage Point, you don't have to. Text the word money to 411-411 to find out how our technology can forecast market trend changes with up to 87.4% accuracy. That's right, 87.4%. Text the word money to 411-411 to get what you need to stay ahead of market trends and better protect yourself from sudden downturns. Vantage Point's patented technology analyzes huge quantities of global data in seconds. No more guessing when to stay or when to get out. Text money to 411-411 and we'll send you a link to our free demo. Text money to 411-411 so you can better protect your hard-earned capital with Vantage Point. Don't wait. Text the word money to 411-411.
Go to VantagePointSoftware.com for terms, conditions, and privacy policy.
Not having identity theft.
As a doctor and a business owner with 15 employees, I know how hard this shutdown has been on our families and our society. I took an oath to do no harm and promote safe and healthy living. That could mean encouraging patients to take better care of themselves or taking common sense precautions to protect themselves from a virus. I'm confident that the time has come to start reopening our communities. Because we know who is at low risk, we can let these individuals get back to work. We also know which groups are at highest risk and can focus our resources on protecting them. By working together, we have flattened the curve. Now it's time for Main Street to reopen.
By working together, we were able to flatten the curve, but now it's time to flatten the fear. By taking common sense precautions like social distancing, the vast majority of people under the age of 65 are at very low risk. Together, we can open America. Find out more at flattenthefear.com. Brought to you by the Job Creators Network Foundation.
Before and after, the salon has been active in the Richmond, Virginia community, providing hairstyling services for over 10 years. Before and After is located in downtown Richmond at 1917 West Carey Street. Specializing in weaves, extensions, and growing healthy hair, Before and After provides a full suite of hair care services. Expert stylists Michelle Smith and Alicia Clark are well trained to meet your styling needs at Before and After the Salon.
Hi, Chef Michelle here of Mama Show Cafe, home of the Soul Rolls, located at 10811 Hull Street Road. Give us a call at 804-912-1644 or order online at mamashows.com. Ask about our off-site catering options as well as our online ordering through Grubhub, Uber Eats, and DoorDash. Follow us on all social media at Mama Shells Cafe. That's Mama Shells, Seoul, south of the James. Mention Mike on the mic and get a free dessert on us. Special rules apply.
Does your home need a makeover? If so, refresh with quality with LA Labor and Painting, LLC. They make your home sparkle and be the envy of the community. They are masters at interior and exterior painting, drywall. They clean decks. They landscape and remove items you wish were gone. The bottom line is, they refresh with quality, provide professional service, and follow all guidelines regarding COVID-19. Call today to make your home sparkle. You can reach LA Labor by calling 804-972-8014. Call today for the On the Mic with Mike discount. When you mention the program, you'll receive 20% off of the beautification of your most prized possession. Call LA Labor and Painting today at 804-972-8014.
My name is Isabella and you're listening to Mike King Biz Hubby. That's my scam.
And ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to On the Mic with Mike. It's the premier business show here in the Richmond, Virginia area. It is the social enterprise business show. We're coming to you live from the Mike King Biz Studio. It's the global epicenter of social enterprise business here with Al Green on the wheels of steel. We can be reached if you'd like to call us at 804-778-8888. We're here with you daily from 1 to 2. As I said, we'd like to thank Tamika Vincent for coming in and providing the information for her candidacy, as well as her background in being an advocate for children. Next up on the mic is a friend of the program, a branding mentor to me, friend of the program, friend of mine. Ladies and gentlemen, I bring you the real estate rock star, Nicole Reed of Nicole Reed Real Estate.
Hello, everyone.
So, folks, for people who don't know, Nicole Reed sells tons of real estate. She also has her own podcast, and we're going to talk about why real estate is flying these days, her views on it, and how she can help you sell your property. And if you want to do that, you need to contact her. So, Nicole, the microphone is yours. It's not like I got to give you pointers on how.
You don't want to give me no instructions whatsoever.
No. You definitely have it. You got this.
Lord. Okay. Hello, everybody. Again, it's Nicole Reed with Nicole Reed Real Estate and Build Credit LLC. So, you know, I do a couple of different variety of things here on the show with Mike King Biz. Okay. So, yeah, the real estate market is like crazy. It's super hot. Houses are flying off the market right now. So I get a lot of people. We have tons of buyers out there, but we have very limited inventory when it comes to houses for sale on the market, which is one of the reasons why houses are flying off the market. It's a high demand. Sellers are getting $10,000-$15,000 off above list price. It's because we don't have a lot of inventory. So I get a lot of questions from buyers, first of all, just trying to figure out how they can be competitive in this market, because it is a very competitive market, yet you have tons of buyers that are out there looking to purchase real estate, first-time home buyers. A lot of them are in a certain price segment. And here in the Richmond Tri-Cities area, anything below 280, 250 can be a competing market where you're dealing with multiple offer situations for a single home. And what that means to buyers is that although a lot of buyers are in the mindset of getting a discount when they're purchasing a home, trying to get the best deal for purchasing a home, the mindset that they really need to be in is highest and best mindset, being competitive, especially if they find a house that they really like, because these houses literally are flying off the market same day. and you really don't have an opportunity to even sleep on it and think about it. So when you're going out and you're with your realtor, whether it's me or my buyer's agent or another realtor from somewhere else, when you're going out and you're looking at properties, you really have to have that mindset. First of all, you want to be prepared to make sure that you have your pre-approval from your lender, but you want to have that mindset that, you know, you've got to come strong.
Okay. So, ladies and gentlemen, the voice you're listening to is the real estate rock star, Nicole Reed. So when the economy went away and the wheels fell off the economy, it never fell off with real estate, did it?
Well, I mean, if you're talking about COVID, no, I mean, it got crazy.
And I think that, why do you think that? Because when everything else sort of slowed down, you were continually selling homes, showing homes, and getting, as you say, what is it, the keys to close? What's your line?
Giving them the keys to their homes. Like, that's... I mean, my tagline is now, it's changed from helping you with your needs so you can live out your dreams to real estate redefined, because we're doing real estate different here at Nicole Reed Real Estate. And we encompass a lot of different things with real estate, not just your typical buying and selling. You know?
Okay. So before you were up, you were just getting folks ready, you were buying homes, and you realized the need for people to come to the process more prepared. Yeah. And that birthed the credit.
Well, I mean, before I even got into real estate, I was in finance,
and
16 years. So I already know that they needed to come prepared. The thing was, is that I had clients that had the desire to purchase a home, but they just weren't ready credit wise. And sending them to other companies to be able to assist them to get what they need to get and get them back to me, I was losing a segment of business, a segment of clients. And because I knew what needed to be done, it was just like, you know what? Instead of sending them off to someone else, let me handhold this client, because that's what I'm very good at, and making sure that they get what they need, and making sure that, you know, if they have the desire to be a homeowner, I want to make sure that they become a homeowner, getting them through the process and getting them back over to the real estate side of business and finding their home. So that's why, you know, the Build Credit LLC was birthed last year, to be able to assist those clients for successfully getting their credit to where they need to get, paying off debts if they need to pay off debts, getting negative items removed off their credit reports, and educating them on the importance of credit and how they can maintain the credit score that they need so they can qualify.
So what is that credit score now during the COVID epidemic? Has it gone up, gone down? How's lending been recently?
So, I mean, there has definitely been a change with lending, especially like when COVID first started. I mean, lenders were freaking out, investors were freaking out. And so they kind of stopped a lot of their programs out there. So you used to be able to just go out with a 580 credit score and get approved. You got 3.5% down, you can get approved. Even at a 550, you got 10% down, you can get approved. A lot of the lenders, mortgage companies out there, they kind of put a halt to that. To where you needed to have either a 620, some 640, some 660, and even some 680 to even get qualified. So it does definitely depend on which company that you're going through. But I still have lenders that are actually doing 550 and 580 credit scores. They're just very far and few that are doing that. And they may be looking at it a little bit more finer than what they were in the past as well, because, you know, investors are just cautious with that. But on an average, most of your lenders out there, I mean, you really need to have a solid 640 credit score to where you're not being harassed about a lot of things.
All righty, folks, that's Nicole Reed. Nicole Reed, let us know how folks can find you.
Guys, you can find me on my website, NicoleReedRealEstate.com. I'm on all social media platforms, Nicole Reed Real Estate 1. You can catch me live on Facebook with my radio talk show called The Real Playbook.
Real Playbook.
And I'm also going to be on another radio station, so that's going to be coming up here. We're going to be live.
See, folks, that's
starting
what
August the 8th.
That's what we do here. We drop, you know. Well, that's a media tease right there.
Yeah.
She's not giving us everything.
I'm gonna give it to you, but I ain't gonna give it to you right now. We'll talk more about
it. Okay, so folks, what you have to do is make sure you follow Nicole Reed. She, one of the things, so the time is 1:43. What Nicole is a master at is the whole branding aspect. And since this is a business show, could you talk about the importance of branding? She taught me the importance of branding. And that's the was the birth of my King Biz branded on a lot of things, that on mostly everything that I have. Talk a little bit about the importance of that.
I mean, branding is very important. You know, having visibility in the marketplace so people know who you are is important. So for me, when I first got into real estate, it was all about branding me, because at the end of the day, people work with people that they like, know, and trust. And just being able to be visible was more important to me than just getting a sale, you know. And once people start to really see your name, see your brand out there, then you become credible as well. So that has been very important to me. I mean, there's a lot of people out there branding and putting things on their shirts, on their hats, on their faces now with their mask, me included. But for me, I always felt that if I'm going to wear somebody else's name, why not wear my name? Why not put my business out there? Why not promote me? So, you know, that, and that's what I did. Everything that you see, I mean, my car is riding around with Nicole Ree Real Estate.
Your son's basketball team uniform.
The basketball team. I mean, they were riding around with Nicole Ree Real Estate on their name. Anywhere that I can put my name to be visible, because I want to be a nationally known real estate guru out there. And in order for me to be out there and get that type of visibility, people got to know who I am.
And people do know who
you are. And I can't be an undercover agent. So, you know, that's where it all came about.
Yeah, well, no, folks, she definitely is not the undercover agent. Nicole Ree of Nicole Real Estate. We're going to talk about your growing real estate empire, too, because you made some changes recently growing your team.
Yeah, absolutely.
So, folks, the time is 1:45. It's On the Mic with Mike. You can check out my brand at MikeKingBiz.com. That's the shameless plug there. The number here is 804-774-NO. That's my number. I'm sorry. 804-778-8888. You can call me if you want to buy advertising airtime on this show. Just call me. Mike King. The number is 804-778-8888.
I don't know your number, Mike, by heart.
804-774-8305 is my number. So call me if you'd like advertising on this program here, and we'll be back on the other side.
Welcome to the SBA Weekly Business Tip. I am Martin Short with the U.S. Small Business Administration Virginia District Office. Although COVID-19 has presented us with an unprecedented economic period, the SBA is still here to help entrepreneurs, small businesses, and nonprofits recover. The SBA has billions of dollars in guaranteed loans available under the Economic Injury Disaster Loan and the Payroll Protection Program, or PPP. We are committed to helping all small businesses rebuild and recover. Let's continue the recovery process together. Visit us at sba.gov/coronavirus.
Since the very beginning, CEO Magazine has been empowering women to be the chief executive of their lives. Sharon's dream was to create this lifestyle publication that helped women manage the hustle and bustle of their everyday. From hair to makeup and photo shoots to the look of your brand and even messaging, whether you are being featured on our front cover or inside our magazine, or simply partner with us, our team of people go to work for you. You sign up for a complete experience. You can share your story on our social media platform or come and network at one of our events. As CEO, we want to see you thrive, innovate, and create the life that you'll love.
Did you know embroidery is an easy, low-cost way to market your business? Let Godmama Wear LLC assist you with your custom logo embroidery needs. Whether you need shirts, hats, or yoga mats, Godmama Wear can embroider various items. Visit us online at www.godmamawear.com. That's www.godmamawear.com. Let's talk soon.
Hi, everyone. It's Pavi Leitner, the CEO and founder of FinLit, and your family's certified financial educator, dedicated to the financial success of you and your family. Are you not sure where to start with your finances? Or are you looking to sign your middle schooler up for our virtual camp? Book us at www.finlit.com. finlitva.com. That is www.finlitva.com. FinLit is creating a money-conscious community.
Hi, my name is Daquan Woodbury, also known as Chef PQ. The restaurant industry is going through a hard time right now. With COVID-19, a lot of things are going on. Restaurants are shutting down. They might have to even close their doors for good. In the past few months, we've seen how life can change dramatically in a blink of an eye. Fortunately, I've created a system, a proven system, that allows restaurants to stay successful in this new way of life. As the owner of RVA Cafe, I would love to help you through these challenging times. Go to redindigofood.com for more information.
On the mic with Mike.
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 I'm on the mic with Mike.
He's like a guru.
No, he's a businessman with a great radio show.
And he supports the nonprofits.
Watch his show and grow. 1 p.m. Friday. WNTW, yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to On the Mic with Mike. It's the premier social enterprise business show here in the Richmond area. I'm your host, Mike King. In the house with us, we have Nicole Reed of Nicole Reed Real Estate. You can find us here every day, Monday through Friday, 1 p.m. As I said, if you'd like to have advertising in the program to help us get the word out, and you could get your word out too, we would greatly appreciate it. You just give me a call. The number is 804-774-8305. It's the number to reach me at. The station number, is if you'd like to talk to Nicole, is 804-778-8888. We're here every Monday through Friday at 92.7, 100.5, and 820 a.m. So, Nicole, what's happening? When a person wants to sell a home, what are the top two or three things that they need to do to get max appeal and to max out the profit that they can make off the sale of their home?
Number one, contact Nicole Reed.
Whoa.
With Nicole Reed Real Estate, 804-721-7630. That's going to be your number one best bet. Number two, buyers are out there looking for move-in ready homes. So it's all about getting your house prepared before you list it. The reason why I'm successful with selling homes, like my slogan says, everything I touch turns to sold. The reason why I'm successful
wait a second.
And doing
Ladies
that.
Ladies and gentlemen, wait a second. We hear some good things here. Can you drop that line on us again, please?
Everything I touch turns to sold, capitalized S-O-L-D.
Okay, folks, this is a business show, and that is business tip of the day. Everything I touch turns to sold.
It turns to sold. So the key is preparing your house for the market. All right, so the reason why I'm successful with selling at record times and getting multiple offers, not just because the market is hot, but because my clients do the things that are necessary to put their house on the market prior. So sometimes, you know, you've got to freshen up a home. You
yes.
know, if you've been living in a home for 10 years, 20 years, your carpet has been the same since then, guess what? You probably are neither going to put new carpet in. All right, you probably need to freshen up your paint. There's some things that you need to do. Power wash your house, like landscaping outside. Make curve appeal first and then work in the inside of the house. But, you know, like I said, buyers are looking for move-in ready. They're not visuals when it comes to seeing what can, you know, be the potential of a home. They're visuals when it comes to looking at the reality of the home. And when buyers come in a home and there's work for them to do, they're already discounting your price. They're already what could probably cost $2,000 to do. They've given it a price tag of $5,000 simply because they, first of all, they may not have the right context with contractors. They don't know what this actually costs, but in their mind, it's going to take this much money to get this house prepared. And now they're either asking for a discounted price or they're even moving forward to the next house who's already done all of those things because they just want to move in.
Okay. So, ladies and gentlemen, the time is 1:53. The voice you're listening to is Real Estate Royalty, Nicole Reed. So when you talk about getting your house ready, we have a common friend, a person that you work with a good amount of the time, Jen. Could you give a shout out and to let folks know how they can get their house right and some of the services that Jennifer does?
Yeah, well, I mean, Jennifer is a part of my team. So as Nicole Ree Real Estate, some of the things that we offer, number one, is a free consultation for our sellers. So this is a consultation from a professional stager that will come out and walk your home and give you suggestions, ideas, colors, different things that might need to be done to the home, and we take on that cost for you. If you need additional staging, then that's something also that Jennifer can, with AGG Designs, can actually assist you with. But so she's part of the team, part of the process. Once we get you under contract for selling your home, we'll schedule a time for you to actually have your consultation with your stager. And like I said, she's going to start from the outside to the inside, and she's going to prepare a detailed list for you of those things that are recommended that you do based off of her professional experience of what she's seeing in the market with buyers, as well as what we're seeing as realtors in the market with buyers. And also, she's going to kind of make that process a lot easier for you. So you have that checklist. She's going to make recommendations when it comes to colors, if we need to paint. If you're living in the house, she's going to make the recommendations of things that you might want to remove before we put the house on the market for pictures, and kind of set the stage for a staged home. So when buyers come in, your home flows freely. It's decluttered. There's not a lot of stuff. Less is always more, always better. And she's going to be able to come in and assist you with that and give you some clarity and some vision as to what might need to be done before we put the house on the market.
All righty. One quick question. Are there still people out there trying to sell homes on their own?
Yeah. But a lot of times they end up calling us anyway.
They try.
And I'm not knocking it. A lot of times I think why sellers are trying to do this on their own is because they don't really understand, or they're looking at the price. But what I found is that sellers underestimate what they could sell their home for. And if they really talk to a professional like myself, that I could probably and more than likely incorporate what you would pay me as far as commission goes in the sale of your home, and you'll still be able to net what it is that they're trying to net. So I think there's a misunderstanding or representation when it comes to them being able to save more money if they didn't have a realtor, you know, doing it on their own versus having a realtor. But the reality of it is that we could actually probably get you more money than you doing it on your own and still pay our commission.
All righty, folks, that's Nicole Ree. We have about 5 minutes left, or we're going to go through some ideas and things that we're talking about. So, Nicole, give us an idea on the lifespan of or the career trajectory of a real estate agent. You start out selling real estate, then you realize you want to do more. Take folks through the idea, because it seems to be a million real people out there who have real estate license,
yeah,
and only a handful really selling.
That's true.
And so give us an idea of the pathway to where you are as a broker.
I mean, I'm just going to tell you straight up, it's a lot of hard work. A lot of people look at real estate agents and then they look and they think that, you know, we make so much money, it's so easy, they want to get into real estate. So that's why you see so many people jumping in and getting their license. What they fail to realize is that it's very expensive when it comes to marketing, branding, and all those other things to get your name out there. You only get paid when you sell a home. So you got to put a lot of sweat equity in building the business. But you also have to treat real estate as a business. So a lot of people don't treat it as a business. And
that's as a side hustle.
It's a side hustle or a part-time or, you know, something like that. And I mean, but you have to really treat it as a business, because that's what it is. And you have to really be knowledgeable about your market areas, about who it is that you want to, your niche, you know, who your targeted audience is. But you also have to know, like, you got to really put in work. You got to know something, and you got to know somebody. And if you don't know somebody, you got to go out and meet somebody.
Okay.
But, you know, there's steps to that. But that's why you'll see a small percentage, 3% of us actually are selling more than 12 homes a year. And I mean, we got over 4,000 agents here in the Richmond Tri-Cities area. And I think that real estate is definitely a good profession. Anybody can be successful if you're willing to do the necessary things that you need to do and work hard and educate yourself. And in real estate, there's just so many avenues, so many ways that you can actually make money in real estate, which is one of the things that I like, because I have several different businesses inside of real estate. So multiple streams of income, and it's not just all in the sales of what I'm doing as far as selling residential or commercial property. So there's different things that you can do. And, you know, for me, for me, I'm always looking at how I can grow, how I can improve myself, and how I can build a bigger, better, stronger brand. And, you know, I just focus on that daily as far as what I can do in Nicolery Real Estate and how I can bring value to my clients. And that's how I end up with all of these multiple different businesses within the real estate, because it's more so for me wanting to bring value to my clients so where I can be a one-stop shop for them. And I can be the resource that they need for any other resource that's out there that they might need.
All righty, folks. That's Nicole Reed. So for friends of the program, so the folks who have been on 92.7 and 820 AM, they know the Mike and Nicole team for a long time. Now, Nicole's been a sponsor of my program, and I thank you for that. The time is 1:59. Nicole, let people know how they can get to you again when we're tight on time. So.
Absolutely. So you can reach me at NicoleReedRealEstate.com. I'm on all social media platforms, Nicole Reed Real Estate 1. You can also reach me at 804-721-7630. Catch me on Mondays, Facebook Live at 1 o'clock for my radio show, The Real Playbook. And stay tuned for more updates on my new radio show that's going to be on 96.9 FM.
There you go. Folks, it's only getting better. 1:59, 30 seconds to go. I'd like to thank everyone for tuning in. Mike King here. Tune in tomorrow. Tomorrow's going to be great. We're going to have a Modern Love with Paula Pardell of Blue Matchmaking. We're also going to have the Barry Farmer Morning Show team is going to come in. And we're also going to have Johnny James from 6335. We'll be back again telling us about the brunch. I'd like to thank everyone for tuning in. Baby, I'm coming home. I'd like to give a shout out to my wife. Nicole Reed is up there. She's goodbye. Take care.
Breaking news this hour from townhall.com. I'm John Scott. The White House has dropped a bid to cut Social Security payroll taxes as Republicans unveil a $1 trillion COVID-19 rescue package. Senate Finance Committee Chairman Chuck Grassley speaking from the Senate floor.
I look forward to introducing further assistance to individuals, relief for workers and employers, support for patients, providers, and foster youth, and additional flexibilities for state and local governments to fight this disease and the economic pain that has come because of it.
Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell's package is an opening GOP bid in talks with top Capitol Hill Democrats. Also at townhall.com, the Senate's top Republican says some state and local governments are dropping the ball when it comes to Americans' right to free speech and the rule of law.
Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell says some cities are listening to the wrong voices.
They seem to fear far-left critique more than looting and chaos.
So fearful of left-wing criticism, McConnell says some cities have favored rioters over the free speech rights of the law-abiding.
Like when mayors cheered on mass demonstrations but continued to prohibit religious gatherings.
A double standard, McConnell says, undermines the very foundations of American democracy.
That is the rule of law in jeopardy.
Bob Agner reporting.
Violence continuing in Portland, Oregon, but the mayor's demand that federal law enforcement officers get out of his city is not placating rioters. Mayor Ted Wheeler didn't have much success trying to address protesters last night.
I will agree to the statement you made about systematic racism.
Rioters demanding that Mayor Ted Wheeler resign and do it now. On Wall Street, the Dow is down 291 points. The NASDAQ is off 217. More on these stories at townhall.com.
Hey. I'm Andy. If you don't know me, it's probably because I'm not famous. But I did start a men's grooming company called Harry's. The idea for Harry's came out of a frustrating experience I had buying razor blades. Most brands were overpriced, overdesigned, and out of touch. At Harry's, our approach is simple. Here's our secret. We make sharp, durable blades and sell them at honest prices for as low as